So I'm currently in Wisconsin. My Nana lives here. She was in the Hawaii video. And I don't really want to vlog that much for this trip since it's so short. But I will be vlogging. We're throwing her a surprise birthday party. She turned 80 in December, and we were going to throw her a surprise party then. But because of COVID, we weren't able to. So now we are going to be throwing her one this coming Friday. So we're at Alioto's right now, making sure everything is set for Friday. So I'll keep you guys updated on that. Okay, so the party's over. I'll show the aftermath. Nana was really, really surprised. This video will go before everything else. Before all the videos that I will insert now. But yeah, so she was really surprised, and so I'm really happy that she loved the video. But thank you.
What? I know, she has no idea. Like, absolutely, like, no idea. Yeah, Susie didn't make reservations for Fleming, so we came here instead. Damn it, Susie. What's your problem? She's excited for the chicken parmesan.
She is.
Yeah.
It's on the card. Chicken parmesan?
Yeah.
Yellow card.
Yellow
card. What do you want?
I have no idea.
Chicken parmesan for Nana.
For Nana.
Choices are, for tonight, we are having chicken parmesan. We have grilled shrimp served with potatoes. Fresh salmon on some noodles. Okay.
Are they coming?
Is somebody wearing black?
Someone's wearing like plaid with...
I see a white dress.
Oh, yes. I think that's them.
Small. Yeah. Can you tell if that's them?
That's them. Okay.
Oh, here we go.
This is tense. Oh, come on.
Who's this guy?
Surprise!
I probably won't sleep for 2 days. Thanks again to everyone for respecting and I love each and every one of you dearly. Amen. Good night.
Good night. Woo! Birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
So if anybody has a story that they'd like to share about Bonnie, you'll just ask me. Are these going to be...
I'm going to deny
it. Is somebody recording this? Should
yes.
We record this?
Hi.
Or,
hi.
Is that what?
Jennifer.
Yeah, I know.
It's a troublemaker.
Oh, no. She's my DJ. She's
yeah.
All right, Jan. Oh, hi, Lenny.
Our husbands knew each other from school.
Spencer College.
And we had double dated how many years together and stood up for each other's weddings. The guys got along well. We had a good time always. A lot of drinking and having fun. Anyway, Bonnie and I have kept in contact always. She's one of my best friends I could ever say. And I love you.
Love you too.
Aww. 3 pages full. Wow. So you can tell, you know, you're in for a ride.
Are you going to be in my inheritance or not?
No.
Okay, first story. One summer in July, a few years ago, we were on our yearly trip to Amish country. Let me remind you that Amish country is completely deserted with cornfields everywhere. Keep that in mind, okay? Keep that in mind, right? On the way back from Amish country, I was coughing and I got that acid in my throat, you know, when it's extremely uncomfortable and nothing can fix it. I'm complaining to my mom and now to Bonnie over there. There she is. About the acid in my throat. Now I mentioned something about soda fixing acid in your throat, but my mom did not want to stop. Did I mention my mom is driving? She likes to drive and has that control when in Wisconsin, because when I'm on a drive, she'll drive 20 miles an hour and constantly pumps the brakes. I kind of got experience with that today because her gas, like the gas in the car, really accelerates. I was like, that's interesting. So you're basically going herky jerky at 20 miles an hour, you know. Finally, my mother says, if we stop and Nana gets you a Pepsi from the trunk, will you stop complaining? I go, yeah, of course. Because everyone wants a soda on a hot summer's day. So here we are in the middle of nowhere with cornfields surrounding us. We stop in the middle of the road to get the soda out of the trunk. When we stop, Nana opens the passenger door and steps out, walks to the trunk, and pops it open. While Nana is rummaging through the trunk for the unknown Pepsi, a bee decides to visit our car. It flies through the passenger door and into the back seat. I do not like bees, so I open the car door, and the bee flies around in the back towards Kennedy and I. The bee seems to fly away, but, you know, that never really happens. So it comes traipsing back into the car. This time I reopen my door, I jump out of the car and run around to the passenger door, and I'm hoping I do not get stung. Bear in mind, you know, Nana, she is still rummaging for the Pepsi in the trunk. And she's looking at me like, what are you doing? Because I'm running around everywhere in the middle of nowhere. And so I get back in the car and she's still looking for that Pepsi. And the passenger door still is open. When my mom whispers to Kennedy and I, watch this. She guns the car, and we go flying about 100 yards forward. We look behind us and see Nana standing alone in the middle of the road and cornfields, holding the Pepsi, shaking her head. Like, why am I with these people? She comes walking back over to us and says, what are you guys doing? We're all laughing so hard, and Nana got back in the car and drove off.
Second mom, I know there's lots of people in this room that consider you that as well, but you've been the best person to have and to be in our lives, so I can thank you enough.
And he's been amazing. Are you afraid something's gonna jump out? I know what's in there. And I don't even know you. I can tell you right now, it's something blue. Was that right? Is it blue? I just told her, she said we gotta open that.
Rummaging.
Oh.
It's blue.
So, why do you think you got this?
I'm from Wisconsin.
Oh my god.
So, do you want to tell the story?
Yes.
Or do you want me to tell the story? You tell the story.
Nana's from Arizona. No, Nana's in Arizona. And Nana just happened to mention to a clerk, well, that's right, but Your store is just like Pick and Save. You're owned by friends.
She's always saying, I'm from Wisconsin.
I'm from Wisconsin.
So she said every time she goes to Arizona, people will walk up and she'll say, hi, I'm Bonnie. I'm from Wisconsin. So now they got her a t-shirt so she can just point at it when she's in Arizona.
I love that.
Pretty awesome, huh?
Yeah. That is
awesome. Oh, Rick's idea.
Rick's idea?
That's why I was kind of afraid. I wasn't quite sure.
Yeah. So when are you heading back to the big AZ?
Probably in October.
In October? Yeah.
And then we go for Christmas. My favorite twin girls happen to be born on the 16th of December, so we're always down there.
Oh.
For their birthday, of which last year they were 16 on the 16th.
Sweet 16. Yeah. That's awesome.
And old Uncle John's birthday is the 17th of December.
17th of December?
Since the girls began talking, he's old Uncle John.
He's old Uncle John. So the 16th and the 17th. So you have a birthday coming up on the 17th? I love it. Anybody else? Jennifer, you want to share another one?
Sure.
All right, here we go.
Story number two. You ready? Okay. In Kauai, people
are
just a month ago, we had reservations to stay in this hotel with an ocean view. When you ask for an ocean view, you pay a lot of money for an ocean view. You expect the ocean view, right? We get to our hotel room at about 9:30 p.m., which is 12:30 a.m. in Arizona, 2:30 a.m. for all you guys in Wisconsin. Bottom line, it's late and we're all tired. We open the balcony, hoping to see the beautiful view of the ocean that we paid and asked for. What do we get instead? We get some nice trees, a parking lot, a restaurant, and the ocean is all we can grow. So it's not an ocean view. It's the knockoff you say is the ocean, but really isn't. Mother calls the front desk wanting to know what's going on with our ocean view. About a half an hour later, we end up staying the night in a hotel room. As we're getting ready to go to bed, Nana flops down on her mattress. Because, she's small. But she's not too small. She's not small like Jan. But, the bed is kind of tall. And so she just kind of gets up, flops down on the bed. And she asks if we plan on staying here. I said, I'm not sure, we might have to move. My Nana says, to hell with that. Rolls over and goes to sleep.
It was 24 hours of no sleep.
Number three. I really had these thought out, I really had them on a piece of paper. Another story from Kauai. No, Nana, you don't need to worry. It's not that story. As much as we would like to tell it, we will keep that one confidential. Mm-hmm. Here's the real story. I had to give all the details leading up to it. We were singing Take Me Home, Country Roads. It was playing on the loudspeaker. We were all singing the lyrics while we continue singing as Nana sits for Mai Tai. It was a half simile. Okay, we got two more. You guys up for it? You want me to be quiet? No? Story number four. I think it was the first or second year we went to San Diego for fall break with Nana, Kennedy, Mom, and I. We were on the younger side, and so we had a lot more energy back then. I mean, I still have tons of energy now, but that's not the point. There's this amusement park on the pier by Pacific Beach that we decided to walk to one of the days we were there. Once we were at the amusement park, after the long walk, Kennedy and I saw this large-looking roller coaster. Kennedy and I were saying how fun that would be and invited Nana to go on the ride. As you know, roller coasters are very fast and twisty, so imagine Nana Bonnie going on a roller coaster in her early 70s. Sorry, Nana, I had to do it. Ever since that day, I would announce Nana's age to everyone since she'd be so embarrassed about it. She was actually 72 then. She's 80 now, in case you guys didn't know. We get on the ride, and Kennedy is sitting next to Nana, and she takes her glasses off before the ride starts. On the ride, I hear Nana literally screaming. And when the ride stops, I ask her if she's okay, and she's looking at me like, oh, I'm fine, I'm just laughing, as she has a stunned face with tears down her face. Apparently, the people who control the ride did not stop us in time, so we had to go on the ride again. And I remember Nana saying, oh, God, not again, and putting her head in her hands. Can I do one more, Nana? And then I'll stop embarrassing. This is the best one. Well, no, I'm not telling that one that happened on the beach. Don't worry. I could, yeah, maybe I will.
Yeah, I'll do that one next.
And this will be from memory, so I'll probably do worse. It was Christmas Eve, December 23rd. Friends, anyone? Christmas Eve. And we were sitting down for dinner. We were praying before we ate our food. Nana was the only person. Sorry, I can't read tonight. Nana was the person saying the prayer for us. At the end of the prayer, you usually say amen, right? Instead of saying amen, Nana says, goodbye. We looked at her with confusion and then realized what she said. We are sort of laughing about the fact that she said that. Now it's an inside joke.
Goodbye, Nana.
Goodbye. Summer day. Everybody's looking for it. $1 million. It was one summer day in Hawaii. It was me and Nana, we were walking down to the beach, and in Hawaii, the slope, it goes like this, and then it kind of just dips down, and then there's the ocean. So when the tide comes up, it's not like everywhere. The water doesn't splash everybody. And so we're walking down to the rocks, you know, Nana wants to get her feet in the sand. And she is walking, and the slope is getting so bad that she starts to teeter a little too close to one side. So, next thing I know...
This is 9 in the morning, people.
Are you drinking my
time
already?
I am. Next thing I know, she's walking to one side. She's like, okay, well, I'm going down. Plops right in the sand. Just sits right in the sand.
The wave that came in.
Yeah. And then the wave kind of like interacted with her falling down. So she looks over. So Mom is in the middle of watching all this. She's like, oh, what is going on here? So she looks at her and then Nana's just going, whoa. So then I come up and I was like, oh, look, there's Kennedy. And Mom's like, hey, you need to help Nana get up. So I walk over to her and Kennedy's trying to, you know, hoist her up. And that's not working because, no, the slant is really not helping us. And so I have to go and help her, and then Kennedy doesn't like the sand. And so she's holding one hand, kind of helping me lift her up, and then she just lets go of that hand, ew, sand, ew, ew, ew. So I'm like, okay, great, now I have to deal with, you know, picking her up, hoisting her up. We finally got her up, we gotta have Kennedy help.
And we have pictures, if anybody
would like to see.
We have pictures of the
progression. You know, the progression of picking her up.
Out at our cottage on Big Cedar Lake, we were out having a good time, driving around, and of course he had a couple of drinks. And all of a sudden we were coming in to shore and the boat tipped over. But before that, we had given Bonnie our cigarettes to hold so they wouldn't get wet. And when the boat went over, we thought, oh my God, we gotta get her out of here. So we got her out, and then she comes to me and she goes, but I didn't lose your cigarettes!
And that guy that I love to death, he gives me a challenge.
Don't cry, Mom.
He left me, but in a different way, he's still with us, all of us. Mm. And I love that girl to death. Thank you, dear.
Yay!
Nana was talking about Carrie Underwood and how she's so great and, you know, she's just so successful and she's such a great person. And as she's saying that, she starts to tear up, you know, starts to cry. Because she's so proud of Carrie Underwood. So now every time we think that she'll get teary-eyed, we'll go, don't cry like Carrie Underwood.
Oh my God, it's too fun. with affection for and afflictions with the members of the class of 1925. One day you will read in the National Geographic of a faraway land with no smelly bad traffic. Oh my God, this is funny. Inside it says, have you any idea how much money these tests are costing you? You're looking through the eye machine.